A while back, I made a video on how to edit and convert your RAW files using just your Fujifilm camera. Today, I'm going to show you how to do it on your computer, which is a lot easier. And there's a few tricks I'll bet you don't know about. Hi everyone, and welcome to Pal to Tech and to Fast Friday. Today we're talking about the free Fujifilm X RAW Studio software and using that to process Fujifilm RAW files. The software can be downloaded straight from Fujifilm's website, and of course I'll have links to all this stuff in the description down below this video. This free program will work with many Fujifilm X series cameras, and there are versions of it for both Mac and Windows. I'll be testing today on a Mac, but the features are identical. Now, there's a couple of things you need to know about Fujifilm X RAW Studio. First, it completely bypasses your computer and does all of the RAW processing using the camera you have connected to it, which in the case of my overburdened, unreliable, and very messy Mac is probably a good thing. Secondly, whatever model of camera that you connect to your computer, you can only edit RAW files that are shot on that model of the camera. For example, if you connect an X-T4 to your computer, then you can only edit RAW files shot on an X-T4. Third, it's important to remember that you are not using the camera that's connected to your computer as any kind of storage device. All it is really is part of a round trip that your files are making from your computer where you specify the edits to the camera and then back to the computer to be saved. So to get started, before you connect your camera, you need to make a very important setting change. Go into your camera's menu where it says Connections Setting. Make sure that connection mode is set to USB RAW Convert Backup Restore. You must have it set that way. In addition, if you see this option on your camera, and it's on Fujifilm X-T4 cameras in particular, USB power supply setting, make sure that is turned off. This is important if you plan on keeping your camera connected for a while and you're processing a bunch of RAW files. Next, you open the Fujifilm X RAW Studio software. You'll either use a USB-C or USB type cable depending upon your camera model. If you're having trouble making this work and getting your camera to connect to your computer, the most likely cause is the cable itself. Try a different one. Also, make sure that your cable is plugged directly into your computer and not into a USB hub. That can cause problems as well. Then you're going to want to put a fresh battery into the camera, connect it to the computer, and turn it on. And in the software, you'll see the camera version listed right here, along with the firmware version. Now on the left side on the top, that area right there is where you browse the files on your computer's hard drive. You can also connect an external drive and browse there as well. Once you click on a folder that has your RAW files, you will see them appear right across the bottom here. Right here, you've got a histogram, and you can see the metadata and camera EXIF information here. At the bottom where the thumbnails are, there are some filtering options where you can filter them out by only RAW, only JPEG, and you can sort the order by various parameters right here. You see that? Now, the very first thing I would do before I got started is go into the preferences of the program and make sure that image quality priority is selected. Listen, if you're going to do this, then don't worry about the speed. You want the best possible JPEGs you can get. Make sure that it's set to the highest priority. Now, on the right side, there is an area for profiles. We'll talk about that in a minute. Then down below that, that's where you make all of your changes. And this is so much easier than trying to dig into the menu in the camera. To change an option, just click on it. For example, I can change this to a 1:1 aspect ratio, just like this. Or I can change my white balance. And of course, I can change the film simulation. So once you've made all your adjustments to your photo and you're finished, you're ready to process. And simply click the convert button just like this. And it will save the image in the same exact folder that you had the RAW files. You can also do a batch export. Select all the photos and then click convert, and it will export them all at once. If you have a set of settings or a recipe that you've put together that you really like, you can copy it and paste it onto other photos just like you can in Lightroom. Simply hover over the photo, right click, copy conversion profile, select the photo, or you can hold down command on a Mac or control on Windows and multi-select a bunch of photos and copy those over and paste them all at once. Then right-click it and select paste. and it will apply it to all of those photos, see? And there's the final JPEG exactly as I converted it. Let's say you come up with a series of adjustments that you really like and you want to reuse them not just now, but in the future. You can save them right here in this profile area. All you have to do is go to a photo that you like what you've done, click save, and then name it something. Now you can go to another photo and to apply your preset, just click on it. Have a look at this. See? There it is. Now keep in mind that if you browse to a RAW file that was shot with a different camera model than the one you have connected to the computer, these options right here, you'll see them, but you won't be able to click on them. For example, these three photos came from an X-T4 camera, but I have an X-T3 connected to the computer. And you can see how the thumbnails are grayed out. But if you click on a thumbnail, right, you can still see the image. And if you go over here, you can click on these, but nothing happens. And this thing flashes right here to kind of tell you that it's just not going to work. Okay, so now I'm going to connect my X-T4. Check this out. First off, there are different options here. You see that? And there's a new area. Have a look at this. Camera profile. This is the location of the camera profile settings that are on your camera. And yes, you can make a recipe here and save it to your camera. So much easier than trying to do it on your camera. You can come up with some great settings, a great look, and then save it to your camera and use it when you're out and about. So for this photo right here, I'm gonna go with classic negative. I'm gonna put a little bit of grain on it. I think I'll bring down the highlights just a little bit. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna click save camera profile, and I'm gonna choose something that I haven't already set up in the camera yet. So I'll say custom 3, click save. Now I can name it. I'll call this field brown, right? Click OK. Now check this out. I'm gonna disconnect the camera from the computer, okay? And I'm gonna have a look now on the camera menu system. If I go into my IQ settings, select custom setting, there it is, right in my camera. How cool is that? Okay, so I mentioned earlier that it's not possible to use RAW files from one camera model that are different than the camera model connected to the computer. Let me tell you something. Fujifilm has this thing locked down like Fort Knox. I tried first hacking the EXIF data by changing the software to make it read X-T4, right? Changing that to X-T4 and then going ahead and processing that. But when I try and access it with an X-T4 camera, look at this. It just doesn't work, see? So the next thing I tried doing was using a hex editor to hack into the actual machine language of the RAW file itself. So I tried opening up the RAW file right here, and there's the actual code of the file. Look at this. See that? And look it up here. They bury this. X-T3. So then I tried to do a search and replace X-T3 with X-T4 right in the code itself of the RAW file. I clicked replace all, you see that? And I went ahead and saved it, but now watch what happens when I try and open it. I either get no response right here and I can't change anything, or in some cases, I get this, right? Look at this question mark, which is the program going, ah, what did you do to the code? You know, doesn't work. And I have to give Fujifilm credit. They have made this thing very difficult to hack. I tried, folks. I really tried to find a workaround for you. Well, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. And if you did, be sure to give it the like and subscribe. Next week, this channel will be on hiatus all week. So I will see you back right here on Wednesday, May 19th. Until then, have a wonderful weekend. I'm signing off now, and I will see you in another video again soon. Take care.